Today with static data members. Next topic is static data members. So static data members of the class are also known as class variables because their content does not depend on any object. So whenever we are declaring any class and we are declaring any data member in it, its value depend upon the object. That means for a class, if we are declaring object 1, object 2, object 3, in every object the variable value will be different. But whenever we are saying it as static, the value does not depend on any object. It is fixed for all the objects. They have only one unique value for all the objects of the same class. It is visible only within the class, but its lifetime is entire program. Okay. So what it does, it tells the compiler that only one copy of the variable will exist for all the objects. For example, if we have a student class, we want to keep college name as constant for all the students. Okay. So for that purpose, what we'll do is we'll declare one variable which is static and whose name is whose variable name is college name, SKNCOE. So what we'll do, whenever the object is created, definitely college name will be same. It will not change as per objects. We'll keep it one only, and other variables may change. So static variables are initialized to zero when the first object is created. No other initialization is permitted. Okay, these are the rules. What static variable have the same property as global variables, but they enjoy class scope. Scope is limited to the class. Now let us see how to declare it. Declaration syntax is given here. Class, then class name into bracket, a static keyword is used, then a data type and a name of a variable and a semicolon. Okay, so in the red color here to the right hand side, one example is shown. Class static demo into bracket static integer x. To define outside the class, we can use scope resolution operator, similar to that of how we are using it for function coding. Okay, similarly we can use that. Now let us see how this static variable is used. Let us start with the first two lines, hash include and using namespace. This is same. Now we are declaring a class gfg. Okay, so in that we have public variable which is static integer I. Now the scope of this variable is limited to this gfg. Okay, now next thing we have is constructor gfg. The name of the class and name of the function is same, so do nothing, semicolon, it will end. We will learn about constructor in next lecture. I am going to give you all details about it, but right now just observe what is happening to static. So integer gfg scope resolution operator of I is equal to 1. So we are initializing value of the static variable to 1. Now in main function, I wish to print the value of the static variable. So cout object is created by this line gfg space obj, and obj.i will print the value that is 1. So it will be common for all the objects which will be created. Now similar to that of as we have static variables, we can have static member functions. So what are properties of it? The first is static function can have access to only other static members. So that means static functions can access only static variables declared in the same class. So static member function can be called using the class name instead of object name. So class name, scope resolution operator, function name and parameter list. This way you have to write. Now how to call it, we'll say the example. Before that, let us see how function is written. Member functions that declare with a static keyword is called as a static member function. Now what is use of this static member function? That if we want to create a single function for all the objects, then we use static keyword. So here the static keyword is necessary, then return type of function, then name of the function, and then formal parameter list. Let us see example. It will be understood by you. See here, class gfg, then we have a public section in which a static function print messages declared welcome to gfg. Then in main function we are calling gfg scope resolution operator and print message. Now GFG is the name of the class. We are accessing this function using the class name. We are not declaring the object to call this, and it will call directly the static function. Okay. Now, before going to constructor, next topic we'll see the constructor.